I wore this wedding dress 31 years ago. I saw it in Brides Magazine, and my husband said, if that's it, it's your gown.
I'm sorry.
It's okay, Mommy.
It's the first purchase my husband made for me. I came from very humble beginnings, so that's why it's important to me.
You're making this very difficult to go shop for a new dress.
Sorry.
All right, well, speaking of your dress, I need
Absolutely
to see this dress.
I need to see this dress.
All right.
This is some serious pressure.
Mom's 1980s dress is a classic A-line with a high-neck lace collar.
Oh, wow.
It's yellow.
That can be fixed. The old dress is very 80s,
but it's got the lace, which I love.
The lace is pretty.
But I don't really like any of this.
The good thing is it's well done 80s. There's a lot to work with. The lace is beautiful.
You know, I love that. This is in the theme.
Yes, it is.
It is in the theme.
But it is a little dated. I'm assuming it was all white or ivory when you first wore it.
Yes.
You don't like me right now.
I don't.
Because I'm talking about this dress.
Yes, you are.
What I don't like about the dress is it's a turtleneck.
It is not a turtleneck. It may be high neck, but it's not a turtleneck.
I think I can do better.
Ugh.
Lauren, could you please show us your something borrowed?
Oh my God.
So pretty, so pretty.
Oh my gosh.
It's not the same dress.
It's not.
I am shocked. I love Kelly's dress.
I'm sorry, Sam, I gotta go see this dress. Kelly, it's amazing. Oh my gosh, this is amazing.
I was just totally stunned with Kelly's work.
Kelly has taken Mom's dated dress and turned it into an off-the-shoulder A-line fit for a young bride.
Because it's my job to keep the integrity of the original dress,
right.
I try to keep as many elements as I can. So pretty much all that I got rid of was the neckline. This is all of your original lace. This is the only new piece I built. And after soaking the dress, it came back to its original color.
I love this shape. I love the top. It's gorgeous. I love the train.
So the back of the dress, this is pretty much your complete entire wedding gown has been turned into her train.
33 years ago, I was the most beautiful bride.
I love my dress because my mom made it. It's so romantic, this dress. It symbolized to me all those years that I've been with my husband.
My grandmother made the dress for my mom back in Honduras when she moved here to the United States. The dress was actually left behind for years, but my aunt returned to Honduras and rescued the dress. And so I feel like I should wear it.
How about physically, do you love the dress? Have you seen it?
Physically, the dress looks like a creepy ghost would wear it. Yeah, it's not cute.
Mom, how important is it for you to have Susan wear this dress?
That's the main reason that I keep the dress. So one day, Susan can wear it. It's like a dream come true.
All right.
Can we see it?
Yes.
Mom's rescued dress is a modest flowing chiffon A-line with long sleeves and applied beaded iridescent appliques.
It's in pretty good shape for traveling the world here.
The color is really nice. It's still pretty white. And she did a really lovely job. She hand applied all of these appliques. The pleating is beautiful. The ruching is nice. I love the fabric.
The sleeve is pretty. There's a lot going on.
There's a lot going on.
I do not see you wearing this dress.
I don't see myself wearing that dress either. It does not speak to me.
Mom, your daughter is about to jump out of her spicy skin back there.
Ooh.
Oh my gosh. Susan, come on out and show us the bar dress.
Gone is the overpowering, flowy, modest gown, and in its place is a sexy organza fit and flare with ruche bodice and lace-trimmed halter top.
It is so pretty!
Oh, I feel so happy, excited.
This is my dress.
Oh my gosh, there's a spicy something going on down here. And it's sexy. I like the way my hoosits look.
Oh, look at the back. Glamour in the bottom.
Glamour.
Oh,
sexy in the top.
Oh my God.
This is cheese.
Oh my goodness. I cannot believe Kelly remade this dress. the way she did. It is drop-dead gorgeous. It is diva.
This dress has been on a journey, and I used every scrap. All of the bodice was hand-draped, wow, hand-ruched. I wanted to showcase those beautiful curves, and I wanted to give, yeah, you layers and layers and layers of tulle. I finished off this top layer of the beautiful satin piping just to give it that polished finish, and this very recognizable giant beaded applique that was on the front of your mother's dress, it's now on the back.
When I wore my wedding dress down that aisle, I knew that was the dress, and I could tell by the look on my mom's face, that was the dress for me.
What does this dress look like? Have you tried it on?
Oh my gosh. I would literally take this one and like burn it.
Tell us how you really feel.
I must say, I think it'll look better with a few changes.
You think?
Yes.
Let's start by, you know,
removing the hat.
Yeah. I look like a maid crossed with a farmer crossed with a tablecloth. You should never, ever have any of those words cross your mind when you're trying on wedding dresses.
Amy, please come on out and show us the dress.
Oh, yes, yes, Team Kelly, Team Kelly. Oh my gosh, Amy, give that girl a Kleenex. Look at the back.
The back's beautiful.
The back is,
the back's amazing. Wow.
Amazing.
It's a one of a kind on a one of a kind girl.
There's no this, there's just like this going on. I love it. I am caught off guard. I don't look like a cowgirl. I don't look like a rodeo clown. I'm so relieved.
Gone is the out-of-date cowgirl milkmaid, and in its place is a stunning fit and flare with daring low illusion back and crystal lace overlay.
It's just very sentimental to think that part of it came from my mom's dress.
I am completely blown away by how you transformed this dress.
I really wanted to make sure you had exactly what you wanted. You're young and you're a mom, but you don't want to look like a mom on your wedding day. I wanted to just make you the sexy goddess that you are. So I gave you your V-neck, and I was still able to keep the illusion neckline in the back. The hat really had some nice trim on it, and it was just thin enough and just delicate enough to create your strap.
Oh, it's gorgeous. Yeah.
To give the back a balance. I disassembled mom's appliques and replaced them. I also lined the entire train with mom's fabric. And then I couldn't let you walk away without one of those amazing ruffles. So I took a piece and I added it to the bottom of your train so that you will always be followed by love.
Aww. Oh, that's perfect.